In this video, I'm going to share with you how I switched from being reactive to being proactive. Why? And how it created more ease and free time than I could have possibly imagined, but not without an important cautionary lesson to learn. I was the kind of student who put things off. Don't get me wrong, I was studious, but I left everything to the last minute and did it just in time. I put my pleasure time first. But then when I was 19 and in my second year at university, I got sick and I got way behind with my studies. I woke up one day and realized I was this close to exams that really mattered, and I had a huge mountain to climb to catch up. I felt instantly overwhelmed. I started burning midnight oil with coffee and biscuits to keep me going. And to cut a long story short, I had a stress-related emotional breakdown. I ended up doing those second year exams under medical supervision, and I scared practically everybody in my family and amongst my friends with the sudden degradation in my mental and emotional health. That's one of the formative experiences that started me on the path to becoming this kind of coach, by the way. Now, I got through those exams by the skin of my teeth, and when I got to the other side, I swore I was never gonna let that happen again. I convalesced over the summer to the best extent that I could, which was not complete, and made one of the most important decisions of my life: to become uncompromisingly proactive. I decided to implement that decision in three ways. Number one, I was gonna read ahead of my lectures rather than read behind them, so that when I turned up, I was filling in gaps, refining, and connecting the dots rather than trying to create the first foundations of understanding. Number two, I decided to review my notes within 24 hours of writing them, so I could review them while the information was still fresh, before my bad handwriting made them illegible. I'd write them out again if I felt that I needed to. And three, I decided if there was an assignment, I was going to do that straight away, or at least at the earliest opportunity I could. So I'd go straight to the library after lectures and get that work done. That year, I decided that my pleasure time came second. But here's the paradoxical thing. By implementing that decision, I found I had more pleasure time, not less, because things were done. By putting pleasure time second, I ended up with more of it. It was higher quality pleasure time too, because I didn't have that voice in my head reminding me about all the stuff that was not yet done. And when it came time to revise for my final exams, well, of course I studied. I mean, I didn't want to be complacent, but while my mates were cramming under stress, I just didn't need to work that hard. I experienced that third year at university as the easiest year by a long way of all the years where I'd been doing exams. And I got the highest score in my final degree by quite a considerable margin. And that's not because I'm especially smart, because I'm not. I'm actually quite slow on the uptake on a lot of things. I just got organized and did my groundwork ahead of time. And I learned some really important lessons from that experience. Number one, I waited too long to realize I needed to make a shift. Don't wait too long. I ended up doing it to rescue myself from a crisis. I had let it become a catastrophe. Number two, it can be quite hard work to get back on top when you've let yourself get behind. Don't underestimate the work. You will have to put some hours in, possibly some tough hours. If the work comes in at the rate of 10 units a day, you might have to be shifting it at the rate of 15 units a day, and it might take some time to shift the backlog. But three, once you are on top, it's easy to stay there, as long as you commit to the habits that you need to have. That means making a real decision to be this way. A real decision, a not going back decision, not a vague wish or a fluffy intent. But there's something important that I've missed out from what I've told you, and that's because I didn't realize it myself until much, much later. You see, I took that spirit of proactivity into everything that I did. It had become my golden rule, the way to be at everything. And it worked a lot of the time. No more last minute tax returns, no more last minute bill paying. But you know what? I got overwhelmed again, not by getting behind this time, but by it being too much work to stay on top of everything. One of my mentors once said that today's insightful action is tomorrow's problem behavior. This was that. I'd overapplied my way of being and it broke down. Plus, there's a lot of waste in trying to cover all of your bases up front, because a lot of what you're trying to mitigate simply won't happen. There's a lot to be said for doing just the right amount at just the right time. And that's when I realized that proactivity and reactivity are actually yin and yang like pairs, like sleep and wakefulness, exercise and resting. They're opposites, but functional living requires both in harmony, both at the right time. And our difficulties often stem from the fact that we do each at the wrong time, or we try to use each too much, like I did. And it's not about balance either. You don't balance sleep and wakefulness. You don't go around half asleep and half awake all the time. It's about knowing when it's the right time for sleep and when it's the right time for wakefulness. Same with proactive and reactive. But how can you tell? With inner clarity, by clearing your mind through mindful practices so you can hear your inner wisdom speaking. And that's what I urge you to do. But what that doesn't answer is what to do if you simply don't have time for these mindful practices. Well, to answer that question, watch this video here. This is Steve, wishing you health and happiness.